Americans always go for success, you know, but a flop, if great enough, can sometimes succeed in a bigger way than success. Now, you talk about the crazy 20s. One of the wildest heroes in America happened in the serious 30s. While the country was being impressed by record-breaking flights around the world and across the country from coast to coast, another kind of aviation personality made a bid for fame. A young man named Douglas G. Corrigan, an unknown who had turned up his nose at requests for clearance of his flight. A flight, incidentally, supposedly headed for California. When he boarded his $900 nine-year-old Curtis Robin and he took off from Floyd Bennett Field, they thought he was going to California. But before anybody knew it, this beat-up plane of his landed in Dublin, Ireland. Well, a delighted America gave him a rousing welcome home. Wrong Way Corrigan, they called him. The joke caught on and appealed to millions. Fated and dined, he became the toast of New York. And incidentally, such a toast that his ticker tape parade out-ticketed such greats preceding him like Lindbergh and Hughes and Earhart. And I dare say out-ticketed any that followed him, too. It just proved once again that in America, if you're going to make a boo-boo, man, make it a big one. Did he go wrong? That's the question. Did he go wrong? Or is he going to have the last laugh? You can't tell certainly by looking at his face. Well, aviation's come a long way since Mr. Corrigan went the wrong way. And the United States Marine Corps has not only kept pace with aviation's amazing growth, but the Marine Air Arm has led the way. Not very long ago, the Corps announced an exacting new program open to qualified men with 2 years of college education, a program that leads to the wings of gold worn by the Marine Corps' aviation officer. It's the Marine Corps Aviation Cadet Program, MARCAD. The young man, 18 to 25, who can meet MARCAD's exacting standards, takes 18 months flight training at Pensacola, Florida. The course is thorough, starting with pre-flight and including every phase from aerology to landing on a carrier at sea. Once commissioned as a second lieutenant, the Marine Aviation Officer pilots the latest jets or helicopters, and while still in training, earns top pay and enjoys all the advantages of this great military organization. So, gentlemen, check your Marine Corps representative about MARCAD. We haven't even started yet with the great features in America's Newsreel album, but that's all for today. Next time, we'll show you more. This is Dennis James speaking for the Marine Corps, reminding you the Marine Corps builds men.